The fast Fourier transform is an instance of the discrete Fourier transform, which, as we've said, has its own significance in various branches of mathematics, physics, and engineering, signal processing most especially. In the study of algorithms, however, the fast Fourier transform is most interesting for its role in a very practical and very fast way of convolving two sequences of numbers. We'll illustrate convolution by an example. We are given two sequences of numbers shown here, we'll call them A and B, and we want to obtain a new sequence defined by this formula here, where the kth element in the sequence is the sum from 0 to k over I of AI times B sub k minus I. We can visualize convolution by reversing the order of B and lining it up with A so that the zeroth element of B is under the kth element of A. This is the alignment for k equals 0. Then we multiply all elements that overlap and add up these products. For k equals 0, this is 2 times 1, which is 2. So we'll write down that C0 is equal to 2. For k equals 1, we shift the sequence over, multiply the corresponding elements, and add those up. That's a total of 0, and that becomes C1. For k equals 2, we shift the B sequence over again, multiply the corresponding elements, and add them up for a total of 5. And we continue sliding B along, doing these products, and then summing all things together. And we keep doing this until there is no more overlap left. Convolution has many applications, but the one that will be most convenient for us to talk about is multiplying polynomials. Given two coefficients of polynomials, we can find the coefficients of the product just by convolving the two sequences of coefficients. In fact, we can easily repeat the example we just did, but in the context of polynomial multiplication. First, I line things up so that we get the constant terms, and that product is 2. Then we line them up so that we get the linear terms, 0 times x. Then we line them up so we get the quadratic terms, 5 times x squared, and so forth, and so on. How long does this process take? Well, for each element in the longer sequence, we had to do as many multiplications and additions as there are elements in the shorter sequences. Sometimes it was a little shorter around the edges because the shorter one ran off the edge of the longer one, but on average it was at least about half. Therefore, we can say that convolving two sequences via the naive strategy outlined here takes theta n times m operations, where n and m are the lengths of the sequences. The Fourier transform will give us a way to improve on this.